Ernie wants to play an April Fool's joke on his friend, Bertram. Ernie has a huge collection of Rubik's Cubes, which are 5.6 centimeters long on each side. He plans to fill Bertram's office with them. Bertram's office is, coincidentally, also shaped like a cube, with a width of 2.8 meters. What a funny surprise Bertram will get when he shows up to work on April 1st. A. If Ernie takes out all the furniture in Bertram's office first, how many of his Rubik's Cubes can he fit in there? B. If Bertram can remove one cube per second, how many hours will it take him to empty his office? This puzzle has problems inside problems. Here's our general strategy for solving word problems. We'll make a list of our knowns and unknowns, and translate the sentences from the problem into math language so we can find the relationships between the knowns and unknowns. We write out those relationships as equations. Then we can find the unknowns by solving the equations. This word problem is a good example of how sometimes you have to solve other problems first before you can solve what the question is asking, namely, what is the volume of Bertram's office? And what is the volume of Ernie's cubes? Once we know those things, we can tackle what the question is actually asking. If you'd like to get more help on these kinds of real-world questions, you can sign up for our algebra mailing list. We'll help you level up your math skills. Find the link below. Now to the problem at hand. First, let's find the volume of Ernie's cubes. One of the knowns from the problem is the length of one side, 5.6 centimeters. We need to know the formula for the volume of a cube. To get the volume of any box, you multiply the length times the width times the height. A cube has sides that are all the same length, so you just have to measure one side and then cube it. So the volume of one of Ernie's cubes is the quantity 5.6 centimeters cubed, which equals 5.6 times 5.6 times 5.6, which equals 175.616 centimeters cubed. Don't forget the units. Bertram's office is also a cube. We know that the length of one side is 2.8 meters, so using that formula for the volume of a cube again, we can find the volume of Bertram's office. The quantity 2.8 meters cubed, which is the same thing as 2.8 times 2.8 times 2.8, which equals 21.952 meters cubed. Again, make sure you keep track of the units. Here's a challenge question. Try to picture how many of Ernie's cubes will fit into Bertram's office. We're going to solve for that, but it's a good exercise to let your brain puzzle a bit over this kind of thing. Builds up your mental muscles. I think you're going to be surprised. I just remembered that for this kind of problem, you probably want to do a conversion first, so the units of these two kinds of cubes are the same. Do you see why? First, let's convert that one length of Bertram's office from meters into centimeters. 2.8 meters is how many centimeters? There are 100 centimeters in a meter. So we can use that as a conversion factor, like this. 2.8 meters times 100 centimeters over 1 meter, meters cancel, which equals 280 centimeters. Now, let's find out the volume of Bertram's office in cubic centimeters, the same units as Ernie's little cubes. The volume of Bertram's office is the quantity 280 centimeters cubed, or 280 times 280 times 280 equals 21,952,000 centimeters cubed. Does this change your mental picture of the answer? I suspect initially you thought the answer wasn't that big, until we did the unit conversion. But let us know, we'd like to hear what you think in the comments. Let's now solve for how many little toy cubes will fit inside Bertram's cuboid office. 21,952,000 centimeters cubed times 1 cube per 175.616 centimeters cubed equals 125,000 cubes exactly. How long will it take Bertram to deal with this mess? We know he can remove one cube from his office per second. We want the answer in hours, so let's set up that conversion. 125,000 cubes times 1 second per cube times 1 minute per 60 seconds times 1 hour per 60 minutes. We set up the problem this way so all the units will cancel except for what we want in the answer, which is hours. This method of setting up problems is known as unit conversion or dimensional analysis. It's used a lot in science and engineering. If you need more practice with this style of problem solving, we have a couple of great videos that teach you this technique in detail. Now, we multiply through to get 34.72 hours. Keep in mind, most people work 40 hours a week. If you want to be able to solve real-world problems like these, make sure to subscribe to Socratica High. And if you'd like to receive personal emails about new puzzles like these, sign up for the Socratica High mailing list. Thanks for watching.